about to get to green flag, see the 17R out of Spring Hill, Tennessee. Brad Skinner and Bruce Bill Rocket with the King's Custom Race Engine, Williamson County Septic, Trace Construction, Andy's Towing, Hazy Hog Barbecue, Dixon Plumbing sponsored entry. He's joined by the 50, the Cabin Fever 40 winner here out of Morristown, Tennessee, the Double Down Motorsports Long Run with a big keel, the Fleetwood RV, Tennessee RV Supercenter, Red Vehicles for Life sponsored entry for Morristown, Tennessee, Shannon Buckingham. First lap time, 15.703 on lap one for Brad Skinner. First lap for Shannon Buckingham, 15.921. Buckingham's fastest overall in practice. Let's see how it shakes out here. Skinner's second lap coming up, 15.638. And Buckingham, 15.134. 14.921 to mark the beat. Now 14.921, the top two out of each group will automatically be locked in to tonight's Custom Race Engine out of Knoxville, Tennessee. That's Billy Ogle Jr. in the Harrison Ready Mix Van Over and Sun Concrete sponsored entry. He's joined by the young man out of Fort Payne, Alabama, in a Kryptonite race car with an Oliver race engine. That's JTC Wright. JTC Wright in the center stage, JNR Lumber, Ag Core Farm Systems, Octane Race Products, Core Suspension sponsored entry. First lap for Billy Ogle Jr., 15.739 on lap one for Billy Ogle Jr. JTC Wright on lap number one. He'll go 15.522. Lap number two for Billy Ogle Jr. coming up right here off turn number four. 15.676. And young JTC Wright coming down to complete lap number two. Here he is at 15.512. C Wright goes to second. See the 7G, the Rocket Chassis entry for Cleveland, Tennessee native Craig Greer, the EcoPest sponsored number 7G. And he's joined by the driver out of Clinton, Tennessee, in the 11B, a Capital Race car with a McKeel race engine. That is Stacy Bowles in the Advanced Transportation, Advanced Auto Sales, Keiser Manufacturing, West Haven Speed Shop, Outlaw Graphics, Competition Racing Equipment, Taylor Oil Company sponsored Capital Race car. 16.422, 16.422, a lap one for Cleveland, Tennessee's Craig Greer. Lap number one coming up for Stacy Bowles, a 15.736, 15.736 on lap one for Stacy Bowles. Lap two for Craig Greer, here he is, 16.804, 16.804. And Stacy Bowles coming down to complete his second and final qualification lap here this evening at Boyd Speedway, 15.931, 15.931. So Shannon Buckingham and JTC Wright. Next two cars coming out and see the one of the driver better known as the Thrill, Vic Keel out of Mossheim, Tennessee, and a Longhorn with a Vic Keel. The Land Air Transport Orthopedic Institute of Western Kentucky, Diamond Shine Pressure Washing, Mega Plumbing of the Carolinas sponsored entry. And he's joined by the young man in the number 91 out of Signal Mountain, Tennessee, Heath Hindeman, and a Platinum by Coulter with a Vincent race engine. The Playtime Amusements, Biddy Trucking, Andy Dale Trucking, Rick Coulter race car sponsored entry. 15.268, 15.268 on lap one for Vic Keel. 15.468, 15.468. On lap one for Heath Heineman. And Vic Keel, second quick now, coming down to complete lap number two. Here he is. Still second quick, 14.984, 14.984, second quick for Vic Keel. And Heineman, he'll clock in third quick now at 15.375, 15.375. Got an Ironman Series win up at I-75 Raceway this season out of Colbert, Georgia. That's Kenny Collins and a Longhorn with an Atkins race engine, the Dockery Specialized Transport Southeast. Miscellaneous Erectors, Jinx Drywall, Collins Signs, Thomas Clark Performance, Irwin Racing Supply, Kenny Harris Grading sponsored entry, and he's joined by the 18X, the Troy Baird, Sweet Bloomquist, Andy Durham powered machine of Michael Page out of Douglasville, Georgia. 15.385, 15.385 on lap one for Kenny Collins. Page also sponsored by Baird Transport, Elite Concrete, Baird Towing, and TNT Trucking. 15.283, put Page to third quick, 15.283. Lap number two coming up for Colbert, Georgia's Kenny Collins. 15.330, 15.330 it appears. 15.210, 15.210. So next two qualifiers out. See the young man out in the number 21 out of Lafayette, Georgia. It's a CVR race car with an Ernie Elliott Racing engine. That's Casey Terman. Casey Terman in the Terman's Builder Supply Confederate Garage, Chattanooga Valley Auto Parts sponsored machine. And he's joined by the two-time and defending Spring National Series champion, currently second in series points, out of Austinville, Georgia, D. Mac, Donald McIntosh in the Blunt Motorsports Rocket with a big keel, the Massey Electric, Stires, Captain Lund Excavating, Arnold's Trucking, Tennessee RV Supercenter, Cherokee Millwright and Mechanical sponsored entry. 15.914, 15.914 on lap one for Casey Terman. Lap number one for Donald McIntosh coming up. He'll go 14.989, 14.989. He'll go third quick now, third quick. Behind Big Hill's 14.984. Terman 15.763, 15.763 on his second lap. McIntosh lap number two, 15.130, 15.130. McIntosh currently third quick. Terman is 11th quick here in competed regularly with the Southern All-Star Series in 2017. He's out of Whitesburg, Georgia. It's a Capital race car with a Clements race engine. That's Austin Horton. Austin Horton in the 7E Sales Auto and Truck Ambulance. Horton's Incorporated, Smith's floor covering, Wood Motorsports sponsored entrant. He's joined by the 21 out of Maryville, Tennessee, the Double Down Motorsports Rocket with a Big Hill. That's Robbie Moses. Moses and the Fleetwood RV, Tennessee RV Supercenter, Red Vehicles for Life sponsored entry. 15.817, 15.817 on lap one for Austin Horton. Lap one for Robbie Moses coming up. He'll go 15.490, 15.490. Put Moses in at seventh quick so far. And lap number two for Austin Horton. Here he comes. 15.248, good lap. 15.248. Put Horton into position number five now in Group A. And Robbie Moses, second lap, 15.474, 15.474. He's going to finish eighth at this point in Group A with five cars remaining. Yeah, now the Randy Weaver Racing Longhorn by Weaver with an Andy Durham race engine out of Evans, Georgia. That's Brandon Overton in the CrossFit Overton AF Stone Professional Medical Services. Longhorn by Weaver Mission Transport Stoneland Clearing and Excavating. And he's joined by the driver of the number 11R out of Ocala, Florida. That's Austin Kirkpatrick. Austin Kirkpatrick in an AK chassis with a Byron Corey Racing engine. The AK chassis sponsored entry. Lap 1 for Overton, 15.394, 15.394 on lap 1. That's 8th quick so far. Lap one for Kirkpatrick coming up, 15.542, 15.542. That is going to be 11th quick. And Overton completing his second qualification lap better at 15.129, 15.129. Put Overton into position number four. Second lap for Kirkpatrick, 16.145, 16.145. He'll be 11th with just a handful of cars remaining. See the number 29, the 19-time North Georgia Speedway track champion. Out of Dalton, Georgia, that's Gary McPherson in a Sweet Bloomquist with an Andy Durham engine. The Bob's Towing Dalton Discount, Carpet Discount Center, McPherson Diesel Truck Specialist, Modern Images sponsored entry. And they pull out the backup car. They go to the 31 now to Kingston, Georgia. That is Tyler Millwood and a Longhorn by Madden with a Clements race engine. 15.786, 15.786 on lap one for McPherson. Millwood in the Millwood Plumbing Machine Construction Queen Realty Team Hickson Construction entry at 15.639, 15.639. McPherson rolling off turn number four to complete lap number two. Here he is. 15.911, 15.911. And lap number two coming up for Tyler Millwood in the 31, 15.670, 15.670. Millwood going to end up 13th. Out of Salvisa, Kentucky, the wild child Michael Chilton in a rocket with a Mike Bullock race engine, the Caton Industrial Painting, Chilton Lawn and Maintenance, Parkview Home Center, Dial Painting, Bobby Urban Enterprises, a Bruce Bill Performance sponsored number 97 for Michael Chilton out of Salvisa, Kentucky. Got a little high up in turn two there. Gathers it back up. He'll come down to his first lap. 15.758, 15.758. Good enough for 16th quick here in Group A. Again, first laps on this race car here tonight. Every piece on it brand new with the exception of the engine. That's the engine they've been running all year. His second lap better at 15.655, 15.655. So your top two qualifiers here in Group A. Vic Hill second quick at 14.984. And the top qualifier out of Group A at 14.921 in the number 50. Big round of applause, Boyd Speedway, for Shannon Buckingham, top qualifier in Group A. First two qualifiers out, see the number 99. It's a Longhorn with a Big Hill for the Ditch Digger out of Chatsworth, Georgia, Derek Ellis. The Ellis Contracting Incorporated AutoZone-based racing fuel, Gene's Racing Parts sponsored machine. And he's joined by the driver, the number 7 winner at Crossville Speedway last Friday night out of Headingley, Manitoba, Canada. Ricky Wise in a Longhorn with a Big Hill, the AEI Communications, Orthopedic Institute of Western Kentucky, Turk Enterprises, Derek Sandblasting, Land Air Transport sponsored entry. 15.806, 15.806 on lap one for Derek Ellis. Lap one coming up for Ricky Wise. 15.213, 15.213. Ellis coming down to complete lap number two. Here he comes. Yeah, he'll go 15.869, 15.869. And lap two for Ricky Wise coming up. Here he is. 15.233, 15.233. So Ricky Wise, the mark to beat right now in Group B. Yeah, and we'll roll our next two qualifiers out now. See the 18, the Sweet Blomquist Clements Powered Entry for Brandon Kinzer out of Lexington, Kentucky. The Kinzer Drilling, Quality Natural Gas, Will Kinzer Foundation for Autism Research, Textron Off-Roads, ComEdit Gaskets, Plot Lubricants, New Air Recycling Solutions, sponsored entry. And he's joined by the 19 out of Noonan, Georgia, Trey Wood, and a Rocket with the Clements, the Sharpsburg Takeout, Duncan Automotive, GW Performance, CSR Fabrication, Wood Motorsports, sponsored entry. 15.213, put Brandon Kinzer to the top. He's quick time now in Group B. Trey Wood, 15.457, 15.457 on lap one for Trey Wood. Brandon Kinzer, second lap coming up. Better at 15.034, 15.034. Brandon Kinzer, quick time in Group B now. Trey Wood, his second lap, 15.520, 15.520. Right now, Wood sets third in Group B. See the 1G. It's the Warrior House car sporting a CT525 engine here tonight. Out of Seymour, Tennessee, that is former 411 Motor Speedway track champion Ryan King in the Goddard Guttering Warrior 1G design race cars. Mighty Muffler, Goddard Performance Parts for King Roofing, Crockett Creek Jerky, and the Long King sponsored entry. He's joined by the driver, the number 8, the racing school teacher out of Murphy, North Carolina, David Payne, and a Capital race car with a J. Dickens engine. 15.681, 15.681 on lap 1 for King Payne and the Gibson Motorsports, PPM Racing Products, Payne Excavating, American Race Tire, Interstate Welding, Base Racing Fuel, Schaefer Oil sponsored Capital. 15.178, put the coach into second quick in Group B now. 15.527, 15.527 on lap number 2 for Ryan King. David Payne, his second lap coming up. Here he is. 15.286, 15.286, his first lap of 15.178. Good enough for second quick now in Group B. The driver, the number 9, it's a TNT race car with a Farrell Motorsports race engine. He's out of Englewood, Tennessee. That's Dusty Carver. Carver in the Martin's Body Shop and Ricker Service. West Haven Speed Equipment, Farrell Motorsports, Cobbs Auto Parts and Machine Shop, Stealth Carburetors, and Team DBM sponsored TNT. And he's joined by the young man, second generation driver in the 66 out of Rome, Georgia. That's Jake Knowles and a Bruce Built Rocket with a custom race engine. Knowles Race Parts and Bodies, Berry Construction General Contractor, Kerbo Logging, Martin's Record Service, Bruce Built Performance, Josh Roberts Trucking, JW Motorsports entry. Lap one for Carver was a 15.464, 15.464. Knowles first lap 15.719, 15.719. Carver, lap number 2, coming up. Here he is at 15.402, 15.402. Put Carver in at fourth quick now. Jake Knowles rolling a high side off turn 4 down to the checkered flag to complete his second qualification lap at 15.495, 15.495. Jake Knowles right now rides in position number 6. Next two qualifiers out, going to see the 38. The young man, that's the logger out of Murphy, North Carolina. That is Jamie Oliver. And a Masters built with an Andrews Engine Service race engine, the Interstate Welding, Oliver Logging, Concrete Pumping Incorporated, Peachtree Lumber sponsored entry. And he's joined by the young man in the double deuce, the 22 out of Jasper, Georgia. It's a Longhorn with a big keel. That is Will Rowland. Will Rowland in 22. 15.710, 15.710 on lap one for Jamie Oliver. Will Rowland coming down to complete lap number 1 at 15.425, 15.425. That's fifth quick for Rowland in the Rowland tire. Bojangles Famous Chicken and Biscuits, Jeff Smith Racing, AR Bodies, Freestyle Graphics entry. 15.712, 15.712 on the second lap for Jamie Oliver. Will Rowland, his second lap, 15.638, 15.638. So Rowland's going to end up fifth quick so far. We've got 8 cars remaining. Young man in the 15 from just up the road in Harrison, Tennessee. It's a Rocket with a performance race engine. That is Ethan Hunter. Ethan Hunter in the Super K Express, Hunter Electric Precision Seal Coating, Sweet Beginnings up front carburation machine. He's joined by the driver of the 86 out of Rockford, Tennessee. It's a Warrior with a Phantom race engine. That's Jeff Newbert. Jeff Newbert in the Joe Newbert Collision Center. Carriage Hill Insurance, Birds Automotive Warrior. Lap 1 for Ethan Hunter coming up, 15.564, 15.564 on lap 1 for Ethan Hunter. Lap number 1 for Jeff Newbert out of Rockford, Tennessee. He clocks in, and it did not pick him up. 15.615, 15.615 for Ethan Hunter. Let's see if Newbert picks up on this lap. Yeah, he did not, so they'll need to get the...
Her husband drives the number 17 car, Andy Miller. Happy anniversary to Andy and Andrea Miller. 17 happy years.
And we'll resume time trials, and I believe they may have Jeff Newbert fixed. He's going to be joined by the driver of the R1, Alabutawa, Tennessee, Riley Hickman, on a CBR race car with a Big Hill race engine. 16491, 16491 on lap one for Jeff Newbert. Riley Hickman coming down to complete his first lap at 15240. 15240 for Riley Hickman. That's fourth quick for Hickman in the American Billet Austin Trucking Competition Racing Equipment RH Designs. Tucker's Mobile Home Service, A1 Towing and Recovery. 16368, 16368 on Newbert. His second lap, 15274, 15274. So Riley Hickman clocks in at fourth quick. First car out, Leda Rommel in the 111 machine out of Jessup, Georgia. That is Stephen Roberts. Stephen Roberts out of Jessup, Georgia in the 111 machine. He's joined by the young man in the A8 out of Kosciuszko, Mississippi. That is Austin Arnold. Austin Arnold in a Barry Wright with a Clements race engine, the Billy and Charlene Clark, Bishop and Sons. 54 Motorsports, Johnson Trucking, Jim Arnold, attorney at law. Tollison Motorsports, Meg's Tire Service, sponsored entry. 15770, 15770 on lap one for Stephen Roberts. 16090, 16090 on lap one for Mississippi's Austin Arnold. Lap number two for Stephen Roberts. 15936, 15936. And lap number two coming up for Kosciuszko, Mississippi's Austin Arnold at 15925, 15925. You got to just like saying it. Kosciuszko, Mississippi. Next driver out, he's currently seventh in series points. The young man, the Dixie Speedway regular out of Woodstock, Georgia, and a Capital race car with a Clements race engine. That's Jason Croft. Croft and the Carrier Air Conditioners, Graham and Turner Grading. Croft Heating and Air, GW Performance, Capital Race Car, American Race Tire sponsored entry. Joined by the driver of the J-Zero machine, now residing in Cleveland, Tennessee, John Owenby. John Owenby on a Longhorn with a CT525, the Sam's Restaurant Supply, Frazier Appointment Rental, and M&S Motors sponsored entry. 15107, 15107 for Croft. That's second quick in Group B now. Owenby, 15230. He'll go fifth quick in Group B. Croft coming down to complete lap number two at 15290, 15290. But his first lap of 15107, good enough for this lock-in right now here in Group B. Owenby, 15276. Owenby going to finish fifth right now in Group B. Last driver to time in. He's in the Big Frog Motorsports number 58 machine this weekend. The driver comes to you out of the Sunshine State. He's out of Ocala, Florida. It's the Professor, Ivanent Lloyd Jr. Ivanent Lloyd Jr. in the Augie Motorsports number 58 Big Frog Motorsports entry. He's coming down to complete lap number one at 15486, 15486. Okay. And Lloyd clipped the concrete there. It's going to slow him on his second lap. 15670, 15670. And your top two qualifiers out of Group B, second quick and in the lock-in at 15107 out of Woodstock, Georgia, Jason Croft. And the top qualifier in Group B at 15.034. Young man out of Lexington, Kentucky, Boyd Speedway. Big round of applause for the top qualifier in Group B, Brandon Kinzer.